Okay, we've got a wild question for you today. Have you ever heard of a chicken getting hypnotized? This hypnotized state is actually called tonic immobility. And unlike immobility of the gin and tonic type, it's not typically brought on by any substances. I'm Dr. Michaela, and today's video covers tonic immobility, what it is, how it can be useful, and how to do it. So tonic immobility is when a chicken is physically or manually restrained that leads them to a state of temporary paralysis or immobility. It's actually fear-based. Basically, it's when an animal is playing dead. You know your chicken is in tonic immobility is after you've restrained them, you'll notice a reduction in vocalization, intermittent eye closure, and rigidity. Tonic immobility is a stressful state for our chickens and should not be brought on unnecessarily. In fact, researchers use tonic immobility as a way to measure how stressed your chicken is. The longer they remain immobile after being restrained indicates that they are more stressed. That being said, tonic immobility can be an effective way to restrain our chickens if they need to be treated or given any medical checks, and we need to ensure that they don't move around and potentially hurt themselves more. So, how do you induce tonic immobility? Any type of physical restraint can really induce tonic immobility. Older research suggests that placing your chicken on their side and restraining them gently for 15 seconds can induce immobility for about 60 seconds. How your chickens respond to tonic immobility really depends on many factors, including stress level and genetics. If you do have a reason to induce tonic immobility for one of your birds, remember that it is stressful, even when it's the best or safest option. Try giving your chickens Recover 911 afterwards to help them recover from the stress. For more information about backyard chicken keeping, visit backyardchicken.com.
If you enjoyed this video, like it and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.